to fly that.
Oh, you have to be licensed already to be able to handle the simulator.
Yes, or you need to be on the training program to handle that aircraft, that simulator. Mm.
Have you been in a real simulator like that?
Well, I've been in a fixed-based one, mm-hmm. and it was pretty fun, I'd say. Yeah. The good news is that the add-ons you have for all these flight simulators at home are so accurate that you can hop in the fixed-based or the full flight simulator mm-hmm. and go.
Yeah,
it takes some getting used to, but give or take about an hour, if you're a serious student, mm-hmm. shouldn't have a problem, mm-hmm. right?
So how many years have you been flying, Mike?
I've been, I started in 2008.
That's pretty recent.
Yeah, it is recent.
And how many flying hours have you logged already?
About 100 and plus, 110 I think, something
110?
Like that.
Where have those flying hours taken you to?
Well, all over Luzon, really.
Luzon? You haven't ventured out of Luzon yet?
I haven't had a chance. Where I've had to divert.
That's where you had to divert. All right. Well, this is what you see in a virtual flight sim. You've actually mapped out buildings in where? Makati?
Yes, yes. One of our guys did that. Yeah. He went to each building in Ortigas and Makati, got the GPS coordinates, and put them in the simulator.
Wow, that is terrific. So this is what you actually see if you're flying over Metro Manila. Right?
Yes.
That's the recreated environment of the Makati Business District and Ortigas.
Yeah, so if you want to fly between buildings, go ahead.
Aha, okay. If you want to buzz pedestrians, anyway. So, you're looking at the problems that we had with all the navigational equipment in the AIA and stuff like that, how do you feel as a pilot and also one of the flight simmers?
Well, I think every pilot and every Filipino, I'm sure, feel sad about that. Mm. I mean, it would be sad to see that people cannot come into our airport because of bad weather and our lack of systems.
Yeah.
And I think, and I believe I speak for everyone else, that, you know, it just makes us feel terrible.
Yeah.
But like Sir Joy said, we got to put our heads together and you got to change your attitudes.
Mm. No? What are the people in the flight sim community been saying so far?
Not many has been said.
Not many.
Yes, most of the topics are what do you call this? Dominated by real life airline pilots when it comes to the navigational aid failure.
Yeah.
So flight simmers, well, we listen and learn, which is exactly what I did for the last 8 years. Or so.
But your group doesn't just count hobbyists. I mean, you are a pilot, and there are a lot of real pilots who are in the flight simmers group, right?
That's right. Yeah. That's right.
And they encounter these problems, I guess. At one point or another in their careers, flying careers.
Yes, we have a few people who are in the airlines, and they are victims of the navigational
victims. They actually experience having been diverted during this recent breakdown in the NAIA.
I can count one, yes.
Count one. I think somebody posted a video on YouTube, if I'm not mistaken. That was a flight, I think, from Tacloban to Manila, and that was one of the flights that was diverted.
Oh, that I cannot confirm. Yeah. I don't know about that.
I think we picked it up. Anyway, Mike, thanks very much for coming onto the show. Really appreciate it, and really interesting what you guys actually have accomplished with the Flight Simmers Group.
Tony, it's not just in the Philippines. Yeah. You'd be surprised that in foreign countries, they're actually using Flight Sim to test new technologies, like for the FAA's next gen.
Oh.
The MITRE. Yeah. Which does research for the FAA is actually using our network to test their new new procedures.
Really?
I'm not kidding.
So they're using the Flight Simmers Group to test some of the technologies.
Not our group, but several groups.
Several groups.
We're just one part of an entire online community.
Yeah.
And we also have air traffic controllers.
So they test it in the virtual world before they apply it in the real world.
Yes. Hmm. Yes. You'd be surprised.
So apparently that takes out much of the risk, I suppose. In actually having real-life testing.
That's right.
Well, thank you very much for coming to the show. While we were doing our research on your profile, we found out a little interesting tidbit. Advance happy birthday to you.
Thank you. That's
next week,
in a few days, yeah.
Yeah, a few
That's
days. Right. So our pilot here will be having a nice birthday party in the sky. Thanks very much for coming to the show.
All right, Tony, thanks.
Well, nothing takes the joy out of flying quite like a long wait at the airport. But what if killing time at the airport means getting a massage, watching a movie, and playing video games? We'll take a look at several high-tech air terminals to make waiting for your plane seem like a vacation in itself. Keep it plugged to Future Perfect.
and follow after me. Ako.
Ako.
Si.
Si Benigno Aquino III.
Mataimtim kong pinanunumpaan.
Mataimtim kong pinanunumpaan.
At sigasig ang aking mga tungkulin.
At sigasig ang aking mga tungkulin.
Bilang Pangulo ng Pilipinas.
Bilang Pangulo ng Pilipinas.
And I'm very happy for them. I think that's really the joy. To have put in 114 games and...
Back out, Fisher. Fisher for three. Bang!